Hardy-Weinberg Equilibrium describes an environment where there is no evolutionary change occurring. In order for a population to be in Hardy-Weinberg Equilibrium, allele frequencies must stay constant across generations. There are five conditions that must be met in order for a population to be in Hardy-Weinberg Equilibrium. First, there must be no natural selection. Natural selection causes evolution, which is the opposite of equilibrium. So, all phenotypes have to have an equal chance of surviving and reproducing. Second, there must be random mating. If mating isn't random, for example, if females in a butterfly population preferred mating with red males over brown males, the number of red butterflies compared to the brown butterflies would increase and the population would not be in equilibrium. Third, the population must be large. Errors and by-chance events can cause allele frequencies to change. Luckily, these random events do not make much difference in large populations. Think about it this way. In a group of 9, if there's one mistake, the group is 89% accurate. But in a group of 30, if there's one mistake, the group is 97% accurate. So, larger populations tend to make up for small mistakes, while small populations expose those mistakes. So what exactly are these small mistakes or by-chance events? By-chance events are random events that affect allele frequencies in small populations. This is also known as genetic drift. There are two common types of genetic drift. There's the founder effect and the bottleneck effect. The founder effect occurs when a group of organisms from a larger population establishes a new population in another location. This new population may not be representative of the original population and is likely to have different allele frequencies, disrupting Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. Then there's the bottleneck effect, which occurs when by-chance events, usually a natural disaster, causes a population to dramatically reduce in size. The surviving organisms are completely random, as no allele affects the organism's chance of surviving against this particular natural disaster. The surviving members are not representative of the original population, and so allele frequencies are changed, once again disrupting Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. Keep in mind that genetic drift is most pronounced in small populations, so that is why having a large population is a requirement for equilibrium. Fourth, there must be no mutations in the populations. Mutation introduces new alleles and often causes natural selection, which affects allele frequencies. Lastly, there must not be immigration or emigration. If any new organisms are introduced to the population, new alleles will be added to the gene pool and the frequencies of the alleles will change. If a group leaves the population, alleles may be removed from the population and the frequencies will change. Both examples disrupt Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. So, to sum it up, if all five of these conditions are met, the population is said to be in Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium.